आलयम् नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मीति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण्विदधाति पूर्वं यो वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दुःख्यत्मनिर्मलपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहन्नमत्वान्यत् मे निश्चिता मतिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशानमो मह्यम्। So we are looking at Brahma na jnanendriyana vishayaha. So each indriya is taken initially in detail and then briefly summed up. All the other indriyas are put together and refuted as being the means to cognize Brahma. Indriyas cannot have Brahma as a vishaya. We are looking at chakshu as the indriya, how Brahma cannot be its vishaya. But in the context, sadhu takes up the Ishwara's being Brahma, thereby avatars who are avatars of Ishwara being Brahma and they being cognized by indriyas. Then how is it that the indriyas cannot be cognized by Brahma, indriyas cannot cognize Brahma? Because there are people who have, in the presence of Ramakrishna, have cognized Brahma in the form of Ramakrishna ityadi avatara purushas. So in the end we said that the sharira is not Brahma. Sharira gata Brahma chaitanya is Brahma. Sharira gata chaitanya is Brahma, and that cannot be objectified. That cannot be a vishaya. Sharira is a vishaya, all right, of avataras, but the sharira is not Brahma. Why? Because it is bhutakarya or mayakarya. So the objection to that was, every chaitanya which is sharira gata is Brahma. What is the speciality of Ramakrishna the avatara purushas? So some vaishishtya should be there, and that vaishishtyam is of the sharira. So sharira also is Brahma in the case of avataras. This was the question. Tasmad Ramakrishna dinam jivantara apekshaya vaishishtya siddhaye tadiya sharire eva brahma buddhi ruchita natu tadiya sharira adhishthana chaitanya drushtya teshu brahma buddhi riti chet. The brahma buddhi is not with respect to the chaitanya which is the adhishthana for the sharira, but the sharira itself is Brahma. So Brahma buddhi is with respect to the avatara sharira. If this is the objection raised, this is the way to resolve the vaishishtya, then the guru answers, tanna, that is not true. Why? Shariram baditva Ramakrishnadi shariranam brahmatva vivakshane pashvadi shariranam api badapurvam brahmatvam siddhyet. Brahmatva is not for the sharira. Otherwise, the way you have questioned, you have raised an objection, says the guru to the shishya, tattva drishti, You say that others will also become Brahma. But you look at the flip side. Your objection was everyone is Brahma. So Pashwadi comparison will bring down Ishwara, who has taken an avatara, to the level of Pashupakshadi. So there you look at the flip side. Then Pashupakshi Sharira will also, Badapurva, they will be what? There will be Brahma Buddhi there. Which should not be the case. So Shariram Baditva Ramakrishnadi Shariranam Brahmatva Vivakshane. If that is the Vivaksha, then Pashwadi Shariranami Badapuram Brahmatvam Siddhyet. Before the Bada of the Sharira, in the case of Pashwadi also, it will be Brahma. Bada Bhavetu Jivantaranam Shariravat Karacharanadyavayava Sahitasya Rupakriyadi Yuktasya Ramakrishnadehe Sharirasya Niravayavena Rupakriyadi Shunyena Brahmana Saha Abhedo Nakateta. So the Sharira of Ramakrishna Itya Avatara, so Avatara Purusha Sharira Badha Bhavi, without sublating or negating the Sharira as Brahma, Jivantaranam Shariravat. Like the other Jiva Sharira, the Avatara Sharira also is made up of parts. Karacharanat Javayava Sahitasya Rupa Kriyadi Yuktasya. The Rupa Kriya, all these are done by Sharira. So, Rupa Kriyadi Yuktasya Sharirasya Niravayavena. If you make that as Brahma, then how can the Karacharanadi Avayava Sahita Sharira be Niravayava Brahma? Brahma is Niravayava, partless, has no Avayavas. Karacharanadi Avayava is there in the Sharira, which is true about the Jivantara Sharira as well as Avatara Sharira. And these are the Shariras endowed with parts which make Vyavahara possible. Any interaction is possible between parts of an entity whereby Kriya or any Sambandha is possible. So, Rupa Kriyadi Yuktasya Sharirasya. Ramakrishna Adi on one side and Jivantaras on other side. What is the difference? Rupa Kriyadi Shunyena Brahmana Saha Abhedo Nakateta. You cannot call the Sharira as Brahma. Whosoever Sharira it is. Sharira Murti is Avayava Vat. Avayava Vati in case of Murti. Srilinga. Then how can it be equated with Niravayava Brahma? Abhedaha Nakateta. Tasmat Savayavam Rupakriyadi Yuktam Ramakrishnadehe Shariram Api. Sharira has no Vaishishtya at the level of Brahmatva. There is Vaishishtya. We'll come to that, says the Guru. We'll look at the Vaishishtya. Ishwara Sharira has a Vaishishtya because Brahma Chaitanya has no Vaishishtya. Brahma Chaitanya in Ishwara is same as Brahma Chaitanya in Pashu Pashwadi Manushya. So Vaishishtya has to be in the Sharira, that much I agree. But that Vaishishtyam is Brahmatvam, that is not right. Because it is contradictory in all our understanding. So far, whatever we have studied, it is contradictory. So don't jump to a conclusion that the Vaishishtya is Brahmatva. Brahmatva Buddhi is in Ishwara, in Ramakrishnadi avataras, which is different from the Brahmatva Buddhi with respect to Jivas, because it is all Badapurva. But Ramakrishnadi, you look at Ishwara itself, Brahma as Saguna Brahma, Nirguna Brahma as Saguna Brahma. So Vaishishtya is there. Avataras have some Vaishishtyas. Others are also, in some form they are avataras. Ausha, avatara, Ausha maybe. That Ausha also differs in various avataras. Various avataras, there are how much of the Ausha of Narayana has come to play in the Leela. There is difference between avataras also. So Vaishishtya is there. Differences between avataras are there. definitely there is a difference between jiva sharira and avatara sharira, but that is not brahmatva. So brahmatva buddhi should not be there in the sharira. That much is the derivative or the corollary of the teaching that has gone thus far. Tasmat savayam roopa kriyadi yuktam ramakrishna dehe shariram. We can add api also. Api, even if it is the avatara sharira, avatara purusha sharira, na brahma, then what is the bheda? Parantu iyan bhedosti. There is a difference. What is that difference? Iti yukte jivanam shariram punya papa jhinam. The jiva sharira is born out of punya papa. Remember that the context is of the sharira is objectifiable, brahma is not objectifiable. But then it has taken a detour. You are interested in the details. So the tattvadrishti is wanting to know what is the difference if it is not brahmatva. If you accept it is brahmatva, sharira has brahmatva, then he'll ask, it is objectifiable, then how do you say brahma is not a vishaya? Even if in one case, Ishvara Sharira being Brahma is a Vishaya of Chakshur Indriya Ityadi, all Indriyas in fact. If you accept Sharira as Brahma, then it is a Vishaya of all Indriyas, not only Chakshur. Therefore, Vaishishtya has to be known. So it has taken a detour a little. Parantu iyan bhedosti jivanam shariram punya papadinam. Jiva sharira is dependent on punya papa. Whose punya papa? That very jiva's punya papa. Earlier punya papa karma will decide the next sharira. Next or something which is coming up in future. Even in the same janma, the sharira may change in its components based on the karma. So the future sharira depends, whichever janma, depends on the earlier punya papa karma. Bhuta karyancha and other factor about the jiva sharira, regular jiva sharira, is that it is pancha bhuta karya, put together from pancha mahabhutas. What about Ishvara sharira then? We'll come to that. He says, kincha jivanam dehadyanatva padarteshu avidya balat aham mama ityadhyaso huvati. Sacha adhyasa acharya upadeshan nivartyate. So this particular jiva who is a samsari, whose sharira is not decided by him, he has to take up the sharira for bhoga of the karma, which is karma phala, which is due based on the karma which has been done by this very jiva. And that sharira is put together considering the karma which is due as prarabdha in that particular janma. So such kind of a sharira is put together for each particular jiva. And jivanam dehadyanatva padarteshu avidya balat. They are under the influence of avidya. Jivas are under the influence of avidya, which is maya at the vyashti level, whereas avidya at the samashti level or maya is what Ishvara wields. Even as avatara, they have maya under their control. They are not influenced by avidya. There may be cases where others see that they are under the influence of avidya. We see shoka moha ityadi, oh Sita, you know, Rama says, where are you? So he breaks down completely, like any other human whose wife has been abducted. So he has come down to the level of a regular jiva. This is what is the bhranti for the others. Whether Ishvara associated with the Rama Sharira is Bhranta or not, he isn't. It is for the purpose of the others that the avatara has come up. And those who want the sharira to suffer. There is, you can say punya papa due for each, we'll not go into details, but the Ishvara sharira is due to the punya papa of the jivas. When the time is ripe, then Ishvara is forced to take that kind of a sharira, which is due as a vishaya to such jivas. So for those who have created this sharira based on papa, meaning for their papa, karma phala is due. Some kind of punishment is due. That punishment has to be given by avatara itself. That kind of a karma is due. Then Ishvara has to take that avatara. Similarly, those who have punya, they need to have Ishvara in a particular form. To have anubhava of Ishvara in a particular form, then for their punya also some sharira has to be created. So it's a mixture of samashti, punya, papa, which comes together in a particular way to create a particular sharira of Ishvara. That has nothing to do with the Rama Jiva, Krishna Jiva, karma fructifying into sharira, in Rama Krishna sharira. So the sharira is not punya papa dhina of Jiva, meaning a particular Jiva. A particular Jiva, in this case, Ishvara's avatarana Jiva, has nothing to do with the earlier punya papa, because they do not have punya papa. Then what is it adhina on? What is it dependent upon? It is dependent on the samashti punya papa. And samashti punya papa means not samashti in its entirety. A group which has to interact with this particular avatara in some way, where they have to be punished by that avatara, or they have to be, you know, pleased or derive pleasure from that, the interaction with that avatara, in whichever way. So in that complex setup, there is an avatara, and that sharira is not bhutakarya, it is mayakarya. Therefore, the maya does not affect the avatara also. Avatara sharira may be undergoing some changes as per the punya papa of the jivas around that avatara. So in that background, it is explained, jivanam dehadyanatva padarteshu avidya balat aham mama iti adhyasa bhavati. There is an adhyasa, which is atasmin tadbuddhi, due to the influence of avidya. Avidya is quite strong. That is what we all are struggling against. At the individual level, it is called avidya. The same maya is called as avidya at the individual level. So there is ahankara and mamakara. With what? Dehadi anatma padarteshu. Sacha adhyasa acharya upadeshan nivartate. So there is a need for shravana from acharya, whereby the avidya goes away, ceases to be. This is in the case of jiva. So here itself we understand there is no ahankara mamakara for Ishvara. In the avatara, there is no ahankara mamakara. Bhutakarya, so punya papa dhina, we'll start here. So sharira of Ishvara is not punya papa dhina. It is not bhutakarya, but mayakarya. Here it is samashti, meaning whatever set of samashti which interacts with the avataras, their punya papa leads to the avatara sharira. It is not bhutakarya, it is mayakarya. So reasoning will be given, but I'll give a sankshepa so that we can speed up a little. Then there is no ahankara mamakara unto anatma for avataras. Adhyasa is not possible, and thereby, since adhyasa isn't there, avidyakarya isn't there, maya is under their control, therefore, achara upadesha is not needed. they may take Acharya Upadesha. Rama had a guru, Krishna had a guru, but Acharya Upadesha Adhyasa Nivartate Itina. But why do they take, the Gurukula Vasa and, becoming an Antevasi, why did they all study? Why they studied is all difficult to see because Punya Papa Dhina. Other Jivas had requirements of, for their Punya Papa to be resolved, they needed to interact with that kind of a Navatara Sharira. Therefore, they had to have Antevasa Ityadi. All this can be understood. So now, Ramakrishna Adinam Shariram Tu Na Tadiya Punya Papa Janyam Na Api Bhautikam. So it is not a Bhutakarya, it is not Punya Papa Janya. Parantu Srishtev Prak Yada Praninam Karma Phalad Phaladanon Mukham Bhavati Tada Aptakamasya Api Ishwarasya Praninam Karma Anusarena Aham Jagat Srijeyam Iti Sankalpo Jayate. Srishti has also come up with a Kama. So, Aham Jagat Srijeyam, this kind of a desire, Iksha should come in Bhagavan's mind. And it is in keeping with the karma of the pranis. He has no choice to create the Jagat any which way. The way Ishvara, Jiva is dependent on Ishvara, for every Srishti, every part of the creation, similarly, Ishvara is also dependent on Jiva. What is the dependency? Ishvara cannot create based on his whims. He's a karma phaladata. He is Jagat Karana, all right, but not Karana in the sense the potter is the cause for the pot. He can create the pot any which way. No, I would like to create a big or a small pot. He can decide. But Ishvara is not free in that sense. Ishvara will create the Srishti, will create the Jagat. Srishti Prakriya is there. He will create the Jagat based on whatever is the karma due. He has to deal with it in a very unbiased manner. Therefore, he does not create the Jagat any which way. That is the dependency on Samashti Jivas. So to the Sharira also of Avatara Purushas. Parantu Srishtev Prak. Before Srishti, what happens? Yada Praninam Karma Phaladanon Mukham Bhavati. Whenever the Karma Phala of Jivas are ripe for fructification, each Jiva should be given the exact Karma Phala which is due at that point of time. Put together whatever kind of Jagat has to be created, that kind of Jagat is created. And that kind of Jagat due for creation brings about an Iccha in the mind of Ishvara. Tada apta kamasyapi Ishvarasya. Ishvara does not need anything from the Jagat. He has to play the role. Therefore, apta kamasyapi Ishvarasya Praninam Karmanusarena, depending on the karma which is due of the Samashti Pranis, Jivas, Aham Jagat Srujeyam, iti Sankalpo Jayati. That Iccha comes up and then he makes a Sankalpa, it comes up on its own. Let me create. I should create a world in keeping with the karmas of the Jivas, Pranis, and deliver their karma phala. Which is the commitment of Ishvara? Every karma will unfailingly have a result. Tena sankalpena jagad utpatti rupa srishtir bhavati. Therefore, there is this creation which is manifestation. Really, there is manifestation of jagat. Tatha eva srishte paramapi. And at the end of the Srishti, similarly, Aham Jagat Palayeyam, after creation, not end, create at the end of the creation, Jagat Palayeyam Aham. I should sustain the world. Iti Ishwarasya Sankalpo Jayate. Tena Sankalpena Jagat Rakshyate. The world is protected. Now, in the role of protection, whatever needs to be done, including the avataras. Therefore, karmanusarana sukadukhadi sambandhayo palanam ityuchyate. What is palanam? What is the sustenance of this prapancha which he has created? He is responsible for sustaining it. As long as the kalpa has to be there, he has to keep it going. What is the fuel to run it? Just give me a moment, please. Sorry. So, karmanusarena sukadukhadi sambandhaya palanam. What is the sustenance? Association with sukadukhadi of the jivas based on the karma. Causative. Svatantra karta. That is the sutra in Vyakrana. But the next sutra is tat prayojaka hetuscha. Prayojaka, causative, who creates that? Even that kartrutva bhava has to come up in the jiva so that the jiva associates with a vishaya which will give the bhoga of karma phala which is due based on the karma that he has done earlier. So all that is facilitated by Ishvara. So that prayojaka hetuscha, he is a prayojaka and he is the cause. In fact, he is the very cause. As soon as the jiva becomes mukta, jnanena mokshaha, he gets aparoksha jnana, brahmeva ahamasmi, then he drops the kartrutva, still the things take place, still there is interaction of the sharira, guna guneshu vartante. How does that happen? Ishvara is the karta. Without the kartrutva, Ishvara is the karta, I claim the kartrutvam and become the samsari. As soon as jnana takes place, jnanotpatti dashayam, jiva drops the kartrutva. Still the things do take place. It is not that the jiva sharira drops there itself. Prarabdha isn't over. So prarabdha is also part of this palanam. It sukadukhadi sambandha eva karmanusarana. That clock keeps ticking. As long as the clock is ticking, there is palana kriya. That goes around even without the kartrutva of the jiva, kartrutva of the Ishvara lacking even. Kartrutva cannot be there in the Ishvara. There is kartrutva in jiva which he has dropped. Still there are things going on. So, tat prayojaka hetuscha. Palana sankalpa madhye upasakanam upasana phalatvena Ramakrishnadi Namasaita Murtaya Sarvesham Pratiyantam Iti Chaishwarasya Sankalpo Bhavati. So in the Palana, Avatara is a part of that. Avataras help that kind of a Palana. Just like everything is created, he takes Avatara also. Thereby Palana Sankalpa Madhye, in his Sankalpa, again Karmanusarana, Aham Jagat Palayam. Aham Jagat Palayam in that Sankalpa, there is Upasakana Upasana Phalatvena. Upasana Phala of Upasakas is to have Ishvara Darshana. Need not be in another loka. They want to have Ishvara Darshana here and now. Need not be subtle also. They may have a vision. That is another type of Ishvara Darshana, which is Upasana Phala. There may be a particular Upasana Phala where they have to interact with Ishvara in a particular manner. One may have had Upasana of seeing Ishvara as a child. Someone may see Ishvara as a spouse. All these are there in Tantra works. There are there how to look at Devi also. At various levels, there are interactions possible which are craved for as a bhakta. No, I want you as my family member. And when such karma phala is due, it is not that just wanting. So much of upasana has been done by the jiva, at least entirely through the janma. We can't quantify it, but just to assume, you know, to become, you know, have an avatara in one's own family. I need you to be born as, you know, my son sometime, my daughter sometime. All these sankalpas are there because of the upasana phala being due. So upasaka naam punya, punya is due. Upasana phalatvena Ramakrishnadi namasaita murte sarvesham pratiyantam. And put together all the upasakas, all the, you know, punya karmis, their phala is due. In this manner it comes together, Ramakrishnadi namasaita, in that particular name, particular murti should come about, sarvesham pratiyantam, let them appear to everyone. Iti cha Ishwarasya sankalpo bhavati, as it is due as punya phala for upasakas, etc., punya karmis, we will say. Anena Ishwara sankalpena nama rupadi rahite Ishware Ramakrishnadi namani pitambaradi sahita sundara vigrahascha utpadyante. Thereby sundara vigrahas are born based on the karma phala due for a certain set of jivas, and sarvesham pratiyantam, pratiyantam. Thereby with particular names, in particular time, with particular vesha, with particular beauty, they are born in the body. All these features of the body. Name and form. Nati Ramakrishnadinam vigraha tadiya karmadhina. So they are not dependent on their karma. They are dependent on the other jivas karma. Taishcha Ramakrishnadi vigrahihi sadhunam sukam dushtanam dukhancho utpadyate. And thereby, as the karma is due for the sadhus, there will be sukha, and for dushta, there will be dukha, from the same vigraha, which is the avatara. Yachariram yasya sukha dukha der hetur bhavati tat shariram tadiya punya papa janyam iti nyayaha. So there is a common nyaya as to what is the sharira. Yachariram yasya sukha dukha der hetur bhavati. That sharira which is the hetu for sukha dukha for whosoever, that sharira, tat shariram tadiya punya papa janyam iti nyayaha. That sharira is born out of the punya papa of that very whosoever jiva it is. Anena nyayena Ramakrishnadinam shariram sadhunam sukha hetutvat. So what is the sharira? My sharira is sukha dukkha hetu for me. Therefore, my sharira is a result of my punya papa. This is a common nyaya. Now, this is not applicable in the case of avatara purushas. If you think so, think again, says the sadhu there, as if the guru is explaining. He says, the definition is what? Whichever sharira gives me sukha dukkha, that sharira is caused by my punya papa. Ishwara has nothing to do with sukha dukkha. Jiva has everything to do with sukha dukkha. So the Ishwara sharira is born not out of punya papa of Ishwara, because he has nothing to do with sukha dukkha, but it is born due to the punya papa of others, to whosoever this avatara sharira becomes the hetu for sukha dukkha. Let's say for rakshasas, let's say something that we may not think usually. Let's say Rama crying for Sita. This will give dukkha to some people who are sadhu purushas. They can't see Rama cry. That is due to their own papa. My papa makes me suffer by seeing Ishwara avatara suffer. The same suffering of Ramash may cause pleasure to some rakshasa. Ravana may be happy. That is the result of his some punya shesha is there, because he derives sukha out of that. This is something that we may not normally think, but this is a karma vyavastha. we will think about the flip side, that Rama's or Krishna's Sharira has come to destroy these Rakshasas. Yes, that is, that Sharira is the Papa Phala of those kind of Rakshasas. It is also the Punya Phala of the Sadhus, because it brings about Sukha to them. He protects them. Vishwamitra Rishi was doing Yajna, which was disturbed, which was attacked by Rakshasas, Marichiki Ityadi. They were killed by Rama Lakshmana. Thereby, their Sharira, Rama's Sharira, was, and since it gave Sukha to Vishwamitra, we'll say that his Sharira was a result, one part of that contributing, one part of the contributor to Rama Sharira was Vishwamitradi, their karma. Now, in this case, Anena Nyayana, using this Nyaya, Ramakrishnadinam Shariram Sadhunam Sukha Hetutvat Sadhunam Punya Phalam. Put together some Punya of the Sadhus, then that will lead to Ramakrishnadi Sharira, because it gives Sukha. The Nyaya works well. Asuradinam Dushtanam Dukha Hetutvat Tesham Papa Phalam Chabhavati. And it brings about Dukha. It causes Dukkha to Dushtas, therefore it is the Ramakrishna Sharira is the Papa Phala of Dushtas, earlier karma. This is how the setup is. Now, I'll just explain something here a little more on an aside. On a related note, the definition, the Nyaya which has been given, yes, yat shariram yasya sukha dukha der hetur bhavati tat shariram tadiya punya papa janyam iti Nyaya. Similarly, we saw in the case of Jiva, Jiva also, the Nyaya is very complex. Gahana karmano gatihi. But if you think about it a little, you know, to see how deep it can be. My Sharira is result of my karma is right. However, if it provides sukha dukha to others, then my Sharira also has the influence of others' punya papa. Because there is some karma phala due to them with my Sharira. And this is a case with each and every Jiva who interacts with any other Jiva, any other Vishaya also. Specifically Jivas in this context. So each and every Jiva Sharira that each and every Jiva interacts with, that Sharira is a result of so many other Jivas also. Not only that Jiva, but other Jivas also influence a particular kind of Sharira. Very complex setup. Gahana karmano gatihi. Anyway, moving on. Atra idam tattvam. So what is a tattva here? Jivena purva sharire krita punya papayo phalam uttara sharire tasya eva jivasya sukadukhadi rupam bhavati. So summing up, whatever punya papa has been done by any Jiva in the earlier Sharira, that leads to phala. That phala leads to Uttara Sharira, later Sharira, for that Jiva alone. And then leads to Sukadukhadi Rupa. Sharira leads to Sukadukhadi. So Jiva says Sukadukhadi Rupam Bhavati. What is that? Phalam. Phalam Sukadukhadi Rupam Phalam Bhavati. And it is due to the earlier Punya Papa done in earlier Sharira leading to a different Sharira following. Tasma Sharira Vimana Vato Jivasya Purva Janmani Svenaiva Krita Punya Papa Yor Adhinam Uttara Shariram Ityuchyate. Therefore, it is said that the Jiva's Purva Janma Krita Papa done by himself leads to a particular Sharira Abhimana. He had Abhimana earlier, continues to have Abhimana based on the karma done earlier. Ramakrishna Javai Avatara Purusha Shariranthu Sadva Sadhu Jana Sukadukha Hetutva Sadva Sadhu Jana Krita Punya Papadhinam Meva. Sharira of Avataras is a resultant of Punyas of Sadhus and Papas of Asadhus. Because the Sharira, the very Sharira which has taken Avatara, where Ishvara has taken avatara and so to say has become abhimani in that sharira to deliver the palana result. Result ante palana of the jagat. That sharira being the cause of sukha to sadhus, dukkha to asadhus. And we saw a counter example also. Another flip side mix is also possible. Therefore, it is adhina on others. Sadhu asadhu purushanam. So sadhu asadhu, they are their punya papa adhinam. The sharira is their punya papa adhina, natu Ramakrishna adi punya papa adhinam, because Ramakrishna don't have punya papa itse. Ateva natena sharirena Ramakrishna adhinam sukadukham bhogaha. So Ramakrishna, other avatar adi, they do not have sukadukham bhoga in that sharira. There may be a pratiti for others that there is dukkha for Rama when Sita has separated. There is sukha on Bharata Melana. All these is for, all pratiti is there, but they themselves do not have sukha dukkha bhoga from the sharira or through the sharira. Tasmad Ramakrishna devatara purusha shariram tadiya punya papa jadinan neti siddham. Thereby it is not dependent on punya papa. Then what is it dependent on? That has also been seen. Then what is the vaishishtya? This is one vishesha. Some more vaishishtya has been mentioned, that it is not bhutakarya. It has not been mentioned. In the Jiva's case, it has been said that it is bhutakara. Kincha Ramakrishnadi shariram na pancha bhuta parinamaha. Ramakrishnadi sharira is not pancha bhuta parinama. There is a pratiti of being a pancha bhuta parinama, that it is born from a certain womb in a certain family. However, kintu chaitanyashrita maya parinamaha. It is a mayavi sharira. It's a maya karya. Mayika sharira. It is not maya means, it's a mayavi sharira. So mayavi sharira is a mayika sharira, not bhuta karya. Of course, panchabhutas are also mayika. But there is a certain setup that we study in the manifestation or the srishti prakriya. But avatara purusha sharira is may appear to have the same sequence. But since karma is not there, janma is not in the same manner. There is some vaishishtya there, that is panchi, that is chaitanyashrita maya parinama. Why so? Panchi krita bhuta parinamatve sati sattami. Panchi krita bhuta parinamatve sati krishna sharirasya rajyukrita bandhana vishayatvam bhagavatadishu varnitam asangatam bhavet. In Bhagavata katha, you hear Bhagavata purana, in Bhagavatam there is a description of Balakrishna. Krishna as a child being tied up by his mother, but he is always free. She tires by tying him up, but he is free. The sharira cannot be bound by a laukika rope, because it is a mayika sharira. It is a mayavis sharira. It is a chaitanyashrita maya parinama. Natu panchabhuta parinama. Panchabhuta parinama has to follow a certain rule. When bound by a rope, it has to be, it cannot pass, the rope cannot pass through it. You cannot free, of course, there can be siddhis. That's a different matter. What siddhi did Krishna get from where? There is no earlier janma karma. So there is no memory of some, some siddhi prakara which leads to, child progeny, progeny. Where, the child prodigy is not possible because there is no karma. There is no earlier janma per se. Then how did he get it? He didn't do anything to gain some magical siddhis in that janma. So it has to be a maya karya, maya parinama. So that this is how he explains that bhagavatarishu varnitam asangantam bhavet. What is that? Rajyukrita bandhana avishayatvam. Balakrishna sharira cannot be bound by, it is not a vishaya for Rajyubandhana. he frees himself automatically. Meaning the Sharira frees. If he is always free, but the Sharira is also free, that is another Vaishishtya. Yadyapi panchabhuta karya yogi sharirasyapi bandhana vishayatvam drushyate. So if you object that no, there is a siddhi possible. Some siddhas are there, they do sadhana, they earn siddhis, ashtamaha siddhis, there are 64 upasiddhis also. In those, they can do all of this. What is that vaishishtya there? Yajyavi panchabhuta karya yogi sharirasyapi. Yogi sharira is panchabhuta karya. With siddhis, they may be able to free themselves also. Bandhana vishayatvam drushyate. Possible, magically they can free themselves. Tathapi yogi shariram prathamam bandhana vishetam apadya eva panchad paschad yoga mahimna bandhad vimuktam bhavati. But before the siddhi, yogi sharira is bound by bandha, it can be bound by rope. But after the yoga mahimna bandhad vimuktam bhavati. After the yoga mahima siddhi, it can be freed from the rope. That's an earned siddhi. But before that siddhi, it could be bound. Krishnadi shariram tu na yogi sharira vad yoga mahimna bandha vishayatam yati kintu svabhavatayo bandhadya avishayam or bandhadya avasham. Avishayam and avasham. Being avishayam, avasham. It cannot be under the influence of bandha. Svabhavatayeva. It is not something which is earned. It is different from the yogi sharira, which is gained that bandha avishayatvam by yoga mahima. Tasmat na avatara purusha shariram panchabhuta parinamaha bhagavat padakruta mandukyo upanishad bhashyasya tikayam anandagiri swami bihi ramadi sharirasya bhuta parinamattvam yaduktam tadapi stula drushtinam itara sharira tulyataya eva avatara purusha shariram api pratiyate iti avipraena iti mantavyam. So I had mentioned this yesterday. So sadhu takes up the tika by Bhagavan Anandagiri on Bhagavan Bhashyakara's Bhashya on Mandukya Upanishad. There, in context, he had mentioned that Ramadi Sharira is Bhuta Parinama. But it is not Bhuta Parinama if you inquire into it. So why did he say it then? Isn't it valid? It is valid. It is valid by keeping the context and the audience in mind. So he says, yaduktam tadapi stula drushtinam. In the Mandukya context, he didn't have to explain all this. So he looked at the audience and he explained it with a stula drushti. There is no deep analysis that he has brought out there. He just mentioned that it is also bhuta parinama. It is bhuta parinama because you see it is bhuta parinama. Yes, it is bhuta parinama. At that level, there is an agreement. But if you analyze deeper, then it is not bhuta parinama. It is maya karya. So, itara sharira tulyataya eva avatara purusha shariram api pratiyate. Because it appears, the Ramakrishna sharira also appears as the other sharira. Itara sharira tulyataya eva avatara purusha shariram api pratiyate. Since it appears, iti avipraayana. With that in mind, he has agreed, yes, it is bhutakarya. Like other shariras, which is what we started up with also. And that is the reason that it can be a vishaya for indriya, chakshuradi indriya vishaya. But Brahma is not Chakshuradi Indriya Vishaya because Sharira is not Brahma, be it Avatara Purusha Sharira. Ata eva Bhagavat Padair Gita Bhashyopakrame Sacha Bhagavan Swamayam Vashikritya Ajaha Avyaya Pisan Swamaya Dehavan Iva Jata Iva Cha Lokanugraham Kuruvan Iva Lakshate Iti जगत स्थितिं परिपालयिषुः स आदिकर्ता विष्णुर् देवक्यां वासुदेवादं वासुदेव वासुदेवाद अंशेन कृष्णः किल संभवुः। सो दिस इज इन द उपोद्घातम् गीता उपोद्घात भाष्य देयर इज इट्स अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल भाष्य कंप्लीट समरी ऑफ यू नो व्हाट इज द बैकग्राउंड ऑफ द गीता व्हाट इज द फोकस ऑफ द गीता एंड हु इज द गीताचार्य दैट इज एक्सप्लेन्ड वेरी नाइसली वेरी समरली गिवन। सो देयर देयर ऑल्सो he you know to say why tikakara took that stula drishti why I interpret that as a stula drishti for that he brings up the bhashya elsewhere not in mandukya elsewhere he says that because the tika is in line with the bhashya it cannot be against the bhashya it may give some additional information but it cannot It may be an additional opinion, athava, it may be have possibilities, or there may be add-ons. There is no direct contradiction. And therefore, he brings up Bhashya, why Bhagavan Anandagiri had agreed to it with a stula drishti, not with a deep analysis, is because Bhagavat Padacharya says in Gita Bhashya Upakrama, Upodghata Bhashya, such a Bhagavan, that kind of Bhagavan who is the Gitacharya there, स्वाम मायां वशीकृत्य ही ब्रिंग्स माया अंडर हिज कंट्रोल एंड देन अजह अव्यय अपि सन ही कैन नॉट बी बॉर्न बट स्टिल बॉर्न ही इज अव्यय बट स्टिल बिकम्स व्ययी बाय टेकिंग अप अवतार इवन बीइंग सो स्वमायया देहवानिव स्वमायया देहवानिव नॉट ड्यू टू You know, not due to a regular course of janma based on karma. A particular sharira is being born. The jiva associates with that sharira in the womb and then is born through a womb. All this is a pratiti. But then really how is Ishvara born as avatara? So maya dehavan iva. Iva, not Dehavan, Dehavan Iva, Swamayaya. Therefore, Maya Karya is the Deha. Jata Iva, as though born, not really born. There is a pratiti of Ishvara born as an avatara, but all this is a pratiti matra. There is no real janma for avatara also. Lokanugraham Kuruvan Iva, again, what anugraha is he doing? It is Iva, as though लोकानुग्रहं कुर्वन्निव लक्ष्यते इति एंड देन जगत स्थितिं परिपालयिषुः पालितुमिच्छुः परितः पालितुमिच्छुः ही वी हैव सीन इट इज लेट मी प्रोटेक्ट दिस प्रपंच सस्टेन्ड दिस इज द संकल्प ऑफ ईश्वर व्हेन ही आफ्टर द क्रिएशन इज ओवर एट द एंड ऑफ द क्रिएशन ही हैज टू सस्टेन इट So, jagata sthitim paripipalayishuhu sa adikarta vishnuhu. So, Vishnu is one who has this adikarta. He is adikarta because he is a jagat karana. He has a desire to completely protect and sustain this, protect the sustenance of jagat. Literally, protect the sustenance of jagat. The sustenance has to be protected so that it runs on its own later. Devakyam Vasudevad Aunshena. So with the Vasudeva Aunsha in Devaki, he was born. Krishna Kilasam Babhuva. Samyak Babhuva. That Samyakta is this. Is Iva. Appearing as though everyone else is born. In that manner, iti cha Krishna shariram maya karyatvena varnitam. So, maya karyatvena Krishna shariram varnitam. Not a regular bhuta karya, but maya karya. Tasmanna bhutebhyo avatara purusha shariram utpadyate, kintu tad upadana karanam sakshan maya eva. What is the material cause for the avatara sharira? It is not panchamaha bhuta, but it is maya. Sakshat maya. Itaresham jivanam dehe aham iti atma bhrantirasti. Then adhyasa we saw is there for jivas. unto the Sharira. Ramakrishnadinam tu avatara purushanam na sa bhrantir asti. They do not have ahankara mamakara unto the dehas. Jivasya upadhi bhuta avidya malina sattva yukta. Ramakrishnadinam upadhi bhuta maya tu shuddha sattva yukta. Because the upadhi bhuta avidya, avidya of a jiva, at an individual level, this maya called as avidya is malina sattva yukta. There the malina sattva pradhanyam is there, whereas maya has sattva, shuddha sattva. Not malina sattva, shuddha sattva. Malina sattva means there is mixture with rajas and tamas. Tasma jivasya avidya karya bhuta bhranti hi. Therefore, avidya karya being bhranti, vikshepa being there, that is there for a jiva. Ramakrishna there, maya karya bhuta sarvajnyattvam cha asti. What is the vikshepa for Ishvara, avatara? Maya karya is sarvajnyattvam. So, maya gives you a vikshepa to an avatara, to avataras of sarvajnyattvam. Whereas, avidya gives bhranti. So much of difference is there. Jivasya ajnana prayukta avarna bhrantyor nivrittaye acharya mukhat mahavakya upadesha janya jnanam apekshitam. For a jiva to be free, the ajnana prayukta avarna and bhranti, avarna and vikshepa is there, they have to be resolved, they have to be destroyed, and for that there is a dependency of Mahavakya Upadesha. Jnana. There is an expectancy of Jnana which is born out of Mahavakya Upadesha by Acharya. Hence, being Shravana, it should be Acharya Mukhat. Shabda. Shabda Bodha should take place of Mahavakya. That will lead to Jnana, which will lead to Moksha, which takes away Avarana and Bhranti basically. Jnana takes away Avarana and Bhranti. That is Moksha for jivas. Ramakrishna there, avarna bhranti or abhavena. There is no avarna, there is no bhranti. Vikshepa is not there. So they don't have dependency on jnana. Upadesha janya jnanam na apekshitam. Jnana dependency is there, but jnana is swabhavika, sarvajnyatvat. Maya karya is sarvajnyatvam. For Ishvara, born as Ramakrishna, Iva, therefore, Jnana is naturally there. Upadesha Janya Jnana is not expected. Tathapi Jivasya Antakkarana Vritti Rupa Jnanam Iva Ishvarasya Maya Vritti Rupa Atma Jnanam Upadesham Vina Iva Jayate. Jnana is expected, but Jnana is Swabhavika. Maya Vritti Rupa is Atma Jnana Upadesha. Maya Vritti Rupa Atma Jnanam Upadesham Vina Jayate. Vina Eva Jayate. So, Tathapi Jivasya Antakkarna Vritti Rupa Jnanam Iva. Ishwarasya Maya Vritti Rupa Atma Jnanam Upadesham Vina Eva Jayate. Without Upadesha, there is Jnana for Ishwara. And what is that jnana? We have seen jnana is pramana, prama, pramana as sadhana, and prama as sadhya. Here it is vritti rupa, so vritti rupa prama, which is agantuka. But for Ishvara, there is maya vritti. Whereas for jiva, there is antakkarana vritti. There is a difference. The way jiva has antakkarana, Ishvara has maya. So, antakkarana parinama is vritti in one case, maya parinama is vritti in another case. This maya vritti rupa atma jnanam upadesham vina eva jayate. It is born swabhavata. There is no need for upadesha there. Kintu na tena jnanena kinchidapi prayojanam ishvaranam siddhyati. It is automatically there, but there is nothing to be a result. Resultant of jnana is not there. Why? Because jnana's result is what it will take away ajnana. Because of virodharte nanj. Ajnana has virodharti nanj. It is opposed to jnana. Ajnana itself is not there for avatara purushas. Then jnana being there, sarvajnyatvat, has no role to play. It is there, but has no role to play because avarna is not there. It need not take away avarna. Vikshepa isn't there. It need not take away vikshepa. Therefore, ajnana bhavat tena jnanena ish Ramakrishnadinam tena jnanena vijnana mayavritti rupa atma jnanena kinchidapi prayojanam na siddhyati Ishwaranam. Ishwaranam here is in bahuvachana because Ramakrishnadinam, who are Ishwaras. Therefore, there is nothing needed in their case. Anyway, so it's a quite a long discussion there, but the details are not found elsewhere. It is very interesting to see that. We'll look at it further and we'll close the topic in the next part. We'll continue with Tathahi. Sukham nityam swaprakasham vyapakam namurga adhishthanam buddhya bodhyam buddhir dukyantya nirmana aparam sarva vedanta vidyam pratyak parama tadeva annamattonyat iti me nischita matihi. So we are almost at the end of the fourth chapter. It will end in a couple of pathas. So at the end there is a long discussion and then it lands on tattva drishti jnana. Any questions? Okay, namaste.
Hari Om.
Hari Om.